Why, ever since I've been elected and since my maiden speech, do friends and family call me and tell me to be careful? They'll somehow get you. Why do I feel this? You've come here as a result of a popular majority. I too have been elected. All of us here too have been elected. Why are we in the opposition always at the risk of being called anti-national every time we disagree with this government on issues of national security, on issues of law and order, on issues of policing? Every time we disagree, this government, its troll armies, its propaganda machinery, work overtime to call us terrorist sympathizers, to call us secular, to call us anti-national. Madam, I urge you to put the house in order, madam.
Madam, he wants to speak. Minister wants to speak.
Madam, मैं ये बताना चाह रहा हूँ कि ये अब जब बोल रहे थे और जब ऑब्जर्वेशन ले रहे थे माननीय सदस्य, तो इन्होंने कहा गवर्नमेंट हमेशा जो अपोजिशन है उनको एंटी नेशनल कह रही है। ये हमने कभी नहीं कहा जी, किसी मंत्री ने नहीं कहा, ना हमने कहा। ये शब्द इनको वापस लेना चाहिए, मेरा ये सबमिशन।
मैडम, आई विल स्टैंड हियर। मैडम, जस्ट बिकॉज दे हैव 353 डज नॉट मीन दे विल शाउट अस डाउन। आई स्टैंड माय ग्राउंड। द ऑनरेबल मेंबर डिड नॉट कॉट द पॉइंट। यू कोटेड द नंबर, ही डिड नॉट। I have not said anything against any single member, madam. Please
check collectively, collectively you are saying against the government. You have not said it against one person.
I said the propaganda machinery and the troll armies. I am on record. This is not just a bill for police people. This is a bill that may affect you and me tomorrow. So we must be able to speak in a way that ordinary people must be able to understand.
ये आतंकवादियों पे इफेक्ट डालेगा, आप पे डालेगा
मानसिक रूप से। Concentrates? नहीं, according to this amendment, honourable speaker, that is just the point. You have hit the nail on the head. Honourable Speaker. This bill seeks to do one thing. One is to designate individuals as terrorists without due process. So, कल हमें भी कर सकते हैं, इसीलिए हम बोल रहे हैं. That is exactly what this bill is trying to do. The second thing, it is trying to do two things. There are two amendments that are very worrying. There, I would urge you to please stop them from heckling, Mr. Speaker, sir. There are two amendments here which are extremely worrying. I will go through both of them. The first is the amendment which is to clause 5, section 25, which enables the NIA to be able to go into any state and to arrest and seize and search properties without the permission of the state's DGP or even without the knowledge of the state's DGP. Now, this is completely against the federal structure of our country, because if you see in list 1, you are trying to give the NIA policing powers under IPC and other special acts. The NIA is not an agency that is in list 1. It is in list 2 that the powers of policing are vested with the state. So in this case, the only agency which is on list 1 is the Central Bureau of Investigation and the Central Bureau of Inquiry. Now in this case, the State High Court of Assam has even struck down the constitutional validity of even the CBI. That is a stay order case is pending in the Supreme Court. So in this case, where the NIA itself is under a cloud, you are giving it more policing powers. Even the CBI, when they go in to investigate, they work with the state police. We are a federal structure. States have a certain degree of sovereignty. In this case, if the DGP is not even aware of this and the NIA come in, this is a power which is completely goes against the grain of the Constitution. There have been the second point, which is the most dangerous amendment, is clause 5, section 35. Exactly what you referred to. What you are doing is you are seeking to designate individuals as terrorists in addition to the existing terrorist organization. In section 35, you are creating a whole different test of who is a terrorist. Individuals involved in terrorism, or he promotes or encourages terrorism. Now, the current UAPA in its current form already allows you to take all action possible for individuals that are involved in terrorism. You have section 16, which gives you the death penalty and life imprisonment. You have section 38 to 48, which criminalizes membership, support, and raising funds. So there is no need to designate individuals without due process.